Dear students, now we are going to discuss quarter wave line for impedance matching. It is also called as quarter wave transformer. A transmission line of length lambda by 4 is called as quarter wave line. This line can be used for impedance matching in the transmission line. Here the impedance of a lambda by 4 line matches the load with the source impedance to achieve the maximum power transfer in the transmission line. So this is the diagrammatic representation. Here the quarter wave line can be used to match this load impedance with this source impedance. So we can connect this lambda by 4 transmission line section in between the source and load. Here a quarter wave section of line can be considered as a transformer to match the load impedance with the source impedance. Okay, let's analyze how to match the load impedance with the source impedance using lambda by 4. For that, we can consider the input impedance of a dissipation less line. We have already derived this equation, so we can directly use this expression here. So the general expression for the input impedance of a dissipation less line is given here. Zs is equal to R0 into Zr plus j R0 tan beta x divided by R0 plus j Zr tan beta x. For further simplification, we can take this tan beta x as a common one from the numerator and denominator. Okay, then we can get Zs is equal to R0 tan beta x can be divided. So inside this bracket, this value becomes Zr by tan beta x plus j R0 divided by R0 divided by tan beta x plus j Zr. Here we have to consider a quarter wave line. So here x is equal to lambda by 4, beta is equal to 2 pi by lambda. We can substitute these two values in this tan beta x. Okay. We can get the value like this, Zr divided by tan 2 pi by lambda into lambda by 4. Then here we can simplify this expression. So here it is 2, here it is 4. We can get pi by 2. The same in this denominator as well, okay. So here tan pi by 2 is equal to what? Infinite. Anything divided by infinite becomes 0. Then this term becomes 0, this term becomes 0. We can get the value as Zs is equal to R0 into J R0 divided by J Zr. J can be divided. Finally, we can get Zs is equal to what? R0 squared by Zr. Okay, so this is the value of input impedance for quarter wave transformer. Here R0 is nothing but the characteristics impedance. From this we can find out the value of this R0 squared, that is equal to Zs into Zr. Then we can take the square root value. We can get the characteristics impedance for the quarter wave line is equal to square root of Zs Zr. So here we can matching can be obtained by properly choosing the characteristics impedance of the quarter wave section as R0 dash is equal to square root of Zs Zr. So whenever we can select the quarter wave section with this characteristics impedance, we can match the load impedance with the source impedance. Do you all understand this one? So next one is importance of quarter wave transformer or uses of quarter wave transformer. So it can be used as an impedance inverter. That means it can transform a low impedance into a high impedance and vice versa. It is also used to couple a transmission line to a resistive load such as antenna. So here antenna means it is a fixed load. We can couple a transmission line to match with this resistive load. The next one is a quarter wave transformer may also be used if the load is not a pure resistive. So here it is a pure resistive load, but in case of not a pure resistive also we can use this quarter wave. If it is a open circuited or short circuited line, we can get the characteristics of the quarter wave line section as R0 into square root of 1 by S or R0 into square root of S, where this S is nothing but VSWR range. Okay, so that means what? Standing wave ratio. Okay, and the last one is the short circuited quarter wave line can also be used as an insulator to support a open wire line.